It is now time for part 2 of this countdown. Top 15 theme parks that I've visited so far of 2018. So, yeah, starting up with number 10, I have Walibi Holland. So this is such a charming and unique park. This is one of the strongest one-two punches in a theme park in Europe. I mean, Goliath is an intimate steel classic, and you can't other than just love this ride. It is such a fantastic ride. It is a airtime machine. Might not be that intense, but hey, you can still have a great coaster without being intense. Also, we have Lost Gravity, which has a perfect combination of elements. Most people would say Goliath is way superior. I actually think Goliath and Lost Gravity is quite the same level. I could see both one being better. Other than that, you have some other great coasters like Speed of Sound, Great Recover Boomerang, Express Platform 13, a really really good Vekoma launch coaster, actually pretty smooth, a clone of Rock 'n Roller Coaster. You also have a what's called, you have Robin Hood, a Vekoma Wooden Coaster, which is great. They have a shitty SLC, which I didn't rode. Other than that, you have some other great rides like Skydiver is amazing. They have Space Shot, they have the Doom Ride, which is really good. The Rapids is also good. They're pretty sure they have a Madhouse as well. Some other rides, they don't focus a lot of family rides, but that's okay. It's great and charming and unique, compact park, which I love. So number 9, I have Blackpool Pleasure Beach. This is just the definition of an old school amusement park. It's pretty much Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 in real life with these kind of rides. Like, yeah, they used to have the Wooden Wild Mouse as well, but also they have a ride called Alice in Wonderland, which is like the cat ride in Roller Coaster Tycoon. We have a ghost ride like the ones in Roller Coaster Tycoon. Merry-go-rounds, such a classic and iconic park. Probably one of the most iconic parks out there. And really, really good park. I really enjoyed the atmosphere, as you can see by the score. It's just so unique. I'm not a massive fan of the coaster collection. I love Icon to bits. But other than Icon, I mean, Revolution is pretty good. Avalanche is pretty good. Nickelodeon Swing is pretty good too. Other than that, they have some really really rough coasters. Like, yeah, big ones. Just not my cup of tea at all. Also, Grand National is extremely rough. Big Dipper is, it's decent enough. But they have Valhalla, which is one of my all-time favorite theme park rides. Absolutely amazing. They have a launch drop tower, pretty good as well. But this park is mostly about the atmosphere, which is freaking amazing. So yeah, that's why Blackpool Pleasure Beach is coming in at number 9 on this list. Such a great park. Okay, number 8 I have Heide Park in Germany. This is a really really beautiful park with that massive lake in the middle and just the whole park around this lake. They also have a decent coaster collection. Colossus is closed right now, but it is going to reopen in 2019 and it's gonna be absolutely amazing. I cannot wait to ride it again. They have Desert Races, which is my personal second favorite coaster there. Such an intense launch coaster with some decent airtime as well. They have Krake, the B&M dive coaster, also pretty good. Flug der Dämonen, that's decent enough as well. Schweizerbahn, that's pretty good. Some yeah, pretty good G's in there. Close to say it's better than Flug der Dämonen. Kind of same level, but slightly prefer Flug der Dämonen still. But my second, after Colossus, my favorite ride at Heide Park is actually Scream, the drop tower. My all-time favorite drop tower. Such a forceful experience, and so tall at the same time, which is really great. I like the themings in Heide Park. I mean, coasters like Krake and Flug der Dämonen have some really really good theming. Schweizerbahn has some as well. And yeah, some of the other rides, Not the strongest collection of rides other than that, but a really beautiful park. I really love Heide Park. I'm a big fan of this park. Number 7, I have Hansa Park. So, yeah, I put Hansa Park over Heide Park, actually. Just for now, because, yeah, Kärnan is absolutely amazing. My favorite coaster of all time, and it's just absolutely amazing. So intense, so much airtime. Just all the good things I like about Coaster Pack to One Punch there. It's amazing. Flug for Norway is also an absolutely amazing coaster. With that great launch, one of the best launches out there. In Europe, at least. Other than that, Nessie, such a classic. He's like a mid-card and great, great family coaster. Resende Roller and Crazy Mind, they're decent enough, nothing too special. We have some other great rides. We have the Flume Ride, I actually like that one. We actually have two Flume Rides. Super Splash, not a big fan. You get two red, and yeah, it's just a drop, no theming or anything on that one. I really, really like the other water ride where I'm sitting in a gummy boat, but I don't remember the name. The name is changed now, so yeah, I don't know what it's called. The clock is a capacity nightmare, but it is actually really fun. And now we have Cannon Pulpen. Not a big fan of these kind of rides, but yeah, great they have it still. Other than that, a pretty park in my opinion. Some people think it's a bit ugly, but I just really love Hansa Park. Number 6 is going to be the park I visit the most. That is Djurs Sommerland. I'm a huge fan of Djurs Sommerland. It gets me every time I visit. Every time I'm just blown away about how amazing it is, and I still love it just as much as I used to do. Actually more, I've actually grown on my, not my home park, but the park I visit the most. Okay, so first off, the coaster collection is good, but not one of the best ones. The 1-2 punch is really, really good. Piraten is absolutely amazing. So much airtime, so intense. Juvelen is great. So well paced for a family coaster. Great theming. Really intense for a family coaster too. Feels way faster than it is, just like Piraten actually does. Other than that, it doesn't have Thor's Hammer is a good coaster as well. Skadden is pretty good. Dragkongen is decent. Den Vilde Hønsejagt is a really smooth ride. Jungle Rally is just a kiddie coaster. But yeah, some of the other rides is good. The Uganda Rafting is a really, really good rapids. Colorado River is a great flume ride. We have a water park, which is great. We have this kind of smaller little ride, Bananbådene, which is great. Or it's actually called Jumper Safari, but everyone calls it Bananbådene. We have some flat rides. We'll get a huge flat ride next year called Tigeren. It's translated to Tiger, or actually the Tiger. But that's it's going to be an intimate gyro swing, actually the biggest one in the world. So that's pretty impressive, because we really needed that flat ride. We didn't have that many flat rides before. Also, I love the ride called Speedy Gonzales. It's a ride where you're sitting in a gummy boat and going down by three humps, and yeah, the boat actually flies over the second one, which is extremely fun. But this park also focuses a lot on family areas where you can grill your own food and yeah, buy some food and grill it there. And you have the trampolines, I think it's called in English, I'm not too sure actually. Some playgrounds areas which is great to focus on that as well on a family park like this. Fantastic for the families, but also for the thrill seekers. So that's all from part 2. I hope you enjoyed it. Part 3 will be out tomorrow, so stay tuned for that. Bye guys.